hope it's going to continue to learn more about how to prevent, diagnose, and treat cancer.
Because the future of cancer research is likely more precision medicine, customized and treated based on someone's genetics or a specific type of cancer. With the ultimate goal of improving and longer, healthier lives. Christine Grant, CBC News, Toronto.
We push the boundaries and we're leaders in their field. Now, a new generation of scientists share in the same passion for adventure.
Now, we can find Santa Claus. She wants to be. She's with her body of art, CBC, ABC, Jeff.
Is brought to you by Claritin. Get 24-hour allergy-centered relief with just one pill from the number one non-drowsy over-the-counter brand, with Claritin Clear.
A man is facing a murder charge in the death of his mother. The 88-year-old victim was discovered at his home in the Edmonton and Coffee area of Mississauga last night. Police say she died from blunt force trauma. Her 53-year-old son later went to police and was arrested. Antonio Diano is remade part. An effort to preserve some of the remains of the heritage home continues today as the workers this morning as engineers inspected the site of the Jarvis Mansion. The blaze ripped through the home, suddenly on Sunday it was finally knocked down Tuesday morning. No one was on the card, but there were reports of quarters living in the building. Qualified officials said they believe the fire is suspicious. NBC News only Thursday speaking tonight in the town hall of the University of Toronto. It is being organized by the National Council of Muslims. So the UN is advocating about creative food. And that's why that story is expected to announce a threat to tackle Islamophobia today.
Imagine if we had a 151% rise in robberies in Canada. I think people would sort of have questions or concerns. So even though, you know, the data hasn't increased, that those crimes haven't increased this year, the plateauing from at such a high level is still cause for alarm. And the reality of things is 41% rise of attacks against religious institutions, obviously deeply, deeply concerning.
There will be another similar town hall this coming Friday with Green Party leader Elizabeth May. As well, the organizers said that in the next couple of weeks they will be announcing another town hall with either Andrew Scheer or Lisa Raitt. That I will be here for the duration of tonight's town hall with the same, and I will have more tonight at 11. I'll send it back to you, Blake.
We'll see you then, Sheldon. Thank you. And the world ring of Brad Hammond and Lucas Promises of public events have been steady jumping for months now. Politicians have been previously stepping up their sales pitches for the next number of years. I mean, it should be all that's left is the formal authorization to proceed.
It's a power in the hands of the Prime Minister going to trigger an election campaign.
Of course, I'm calling an election as they do win. That's why an election.
The last run a marathon 7 years gave countries a change in youth. Campaigns have to be at least 36 days, but now can't be longer than 50 days. We're already in that city step where this series can begin any day now, and then this day being September 15th, meaning some new way to strategizing over when the step is done. Justin Trudeau may be a natural success, even reveling. The conventional wisdom started to say, is the fuller the campaign, the better, for permanent.
Long campaigns have given me a longer time for something to start to and it should come out, but you didn't expect, and that's another good thing for a campaign and early for government.
And launching early would put a stop to this.
It's great to be back in Victoria, $290 million over the next 8 years. Housing,
funding announcements and tips on the tax savings dime market code. Plus, the Liberals may want more distance from the jamming effort to talk on the S&P ladder of standards. I'm sure he's in the hospital. And more time to speak to your opponent.
We can watch on the timing of his referral and when he's there.
Johnson has offered three of a high-speed boost over Brexit, the latest an attempt by the PM to force a staff election.
The House will be aware that the motion has not obtained the majority required under the Fixed-Term Parliament Act 2011.
Johnson's effort to force a general election this week after taking office came after a series of groups in the House. First, opposition forces voted to seize control of the parliamentary agenda. Then they passed an extension preventing Johnson from taking Britain out of the EU October 21st. All of this was possible only because 21 of Johnson's own conservative MPs were bad and voted against him. Johnson then forced them from the party, including the Johnson and Winston Churchill. The government of Hong Kong did a major backstage today after months of public protests that it withdrew a proposed bill that would have allowed Hong Kong citizens to be sent to trial for the election. The protest organizers say it took too long and never go far enough. Dr. Hedgehog has more.
Hong Kong has become an unfamiliar place.
The announcement by Hong Kong Secretary Lam came as a surprise today. He was called his tactics delivered to Berkeley's TV station this afternoon. He vowed that the extradition bill, which set out 3 months of protest, would be longer.
The government has finally restored the bill in order to fully allay public concerns.
The original demand was a number of people expected to see people in June. And had this announcement come in, might have prevented some along political crisis. And now,